story of Stranger Things in 3 minutes. Let's begin! Hawkins, Indiana in the 1970s. The federal government funds a project called MKUltra, which was a research program attempting to develop mind control techniques through scientific experiments. In charge of the project is Dr. Martin Brenner. One volunteer, by the name of Terry Ives, is pregnant while undergoing these tests and gives birth to a girl named Jane. Brenner kidnaps Jane at birth, and when Terry attempts to take Jane back, she is apprehended and gets her brain roasted by Brenner. Brenner raises Jane in the Hawkins lab, giving her the name Eleven. She is experimented on extensively for her inherited psychokinetic powers. During the test, Eleven comes into contact with a monster. Brenner tasks Eleven with investigating, but opens a gate to the monster's dimension. Meanwhile, in the suburbs of Hawkins, a young boy named Will Byers is abducted by the monster and taken to an alternate dimension. Will's mother, Joyce, contacts Police Chief Hopper, but when he tells her that Will is most likely playing hooky, she starts to take matters into her own hands. Will's friends search for Will, but instead find Eleven. Jonathan, Will's older brother, explores the woods and comes across a small party at Steve Harrington's house, where Mike's sister Nancy and her best friend Barb are hanging out. Barb is abducted by the monster and disappears. Hopper investigates Hawkins' labs and finds that Brenner is showing fake security tapes and becomes suspicious. Will's body is pulled out of the quarry, and he is pronounced dead. Joyce refuses to believe the body is her son, and Hopper finds the body at the morgue was not real. The boys search for the dimensional gate, but when Elle gets nervous, an argument sparks, and she runs into the woods. Brenner and his team set out to capture Eleven, but she and the boys get away. Elle finds Will alive near Castle Byers, but Barb is dead. Hopper and Joyce save Will. Jonathan and Nancy try to kill the monster with a bear trap. Brenner and his team find the kids, but are attacked by the monster. Elle saves her friends, but vanishes. Will goes back to his family, and everything is back to normal. But not really. Elle, wandering lost in the woods, makes it to Hopper's grandfather's cabin, where Hopper takes care of her. A year later, the boys try to adjust to normal life. A girl named Max moves to Hawkins and makes friends with the boys. Barb's parents still try to find where she may have run off to, unaware of the events that led to Barb's death. Hopper investigates widespread rot over the town's crops. Will has a hallucination triggered by Dustin's pet monster and becomes possessed. Nancy and Jonathan records Hawkins officials' admittance to involvement with covering up Barb's death. Hopper gets trapped in an underground interdimensional tunnel, but Will and Joyce's new boyfriend save him. While exterminating the tunnel, Will collapses and suffers memory loss. Will tasks Hawkins agents to investigate a part of the map that ends up being a trap. Monsters enter the lab and shut down the circuits, and Bob sacrifices himself to turn the power back on. With the shadow monster controlling Will, the group's only hope is to tie Will up and not let his location be known. Will messages in Morse code to close the gate. The monster finds out their location, but Elle saves the day. Joyce and Jonathan overheat Will, and the virus escapes. The boys and Steve lure the pack of monsters to the tunnel, away from the lab, while Elle closes the gate. The lab is shut down for good, the school dance is a success, and Hopper is given a birth certificate, making him the legal guardian of Eleven. And that's Stranger Things in 3 minutes.